Hello, nonsense merchants, welcome back to the channel. And actually, my first motorbike ride of 2024, and I've got a great bike for my first ride of the year. It is the Triumph Street Triple R. I filmed the RS last year, and I thought it was quite firm, it was quite revvy, it was quite peaky, it felt like it wanted to be on a racetrack. I don't live on a racetrack. I live in a land full of mud and cows. So what is the normal R like on the road? This is my first impressions video. This isn't my full review. I'm just going to take it for a ride, talk about the bike. But anyway, let's get going. Oh, it sounds so good. You cannot beat a Triumph Triple for a general feeling of well-being on board a motorcycle. It just purrs, it howls, it sounds naughty. And yes, it is a 9,600 pound motorcycle, which in this day and age is really an affordable motorcycle. But I wanted to ride this bike primarily because I got into an argument with some Americans on Reddit the other day. An American person had bought a Triumph Street Triple RS as his first bike, and the comments were rather predictably filled with things like, "Oh my god, that man, that's way too much, way too soon, you're gonna lay her down," and, "Oh my god, that's insane, you can't ride that as a first bike." All the Americans probably switched off from my video now, bye. And I came to the guy's defense and I said, "Look, I bought a Street Triple as my first bike back in 2009. Yes, it only had about 100 horsepower as opposed to 130 that the RS has now, but it was a great first bike, and I will always recommend a Street Triple to anyone as their first bike because it's got enough power to amuse you, to scare you, to teach you how to ride, and it's not going to bore you because it's got a very predictable torque curve, which you can make the most of as a beginner because it's predictable, but when you do open it up, it goes some. So it's got the best of both worlds. It's predictable, easy to ride, but also makes great noises and will get you hooked on the sport of motorcycling. So anyway, that is generally what I think of the Street Triple. It's not a first bike, but it is. It's a good first bike. It was my first bike, but it's more than that. It's exciting. It's enthralling, it makes a great noise, it's intoxicating, and it will grow with you. So anyway, Triumph has slightly shot my entire theory somewhat in the face by bringing out the Trident 660 as my first triple, as a kind of entry-level bike for complete novices. Fine, go and buy one if you want, but if you're looking at a Trident, don't dismiss a second-hand Street Triple for similar money, because you will be entertained by it for longer than the Trident. More power, more revs, sportier chassis, just more fun and a better noise as well. But anyway, my first impressions of the Street Triple R. Let's get down to that, because this model was revealed at the end of 2022 when they updated the whole Street Triple range and they bought in the fluorescent bastard in the Moto 2 bike and all that kind of stuff. And everyone went out and rode the RS because it had 130 horsepower. This one has got 10 horsepower less, it's 120. Still got 80 newton meters of torque, and some of the cycle parts on this are a lower spec than the RS. So you haven't got Erlin stuff, you've got a lower quality front fork, you haven't got Brembo Styleema calipers slowing you down, but it's cheaper. £9,600, the RS is over £11,000. But I think I want to try this because I thought it'd be a better real world bike. As I said in my muddy intro, the RS is a great engine. It's still got stacks of mid-range, but it's kind of more towards the top end where the fun happens. Whereas this, you can already tell it's got a more similar tune to my original Street Triple, which was just stacks of mid-range go for real world speeds. And the chassis on this as well also feels less bumpy, less committed to super smooth racetracks, and more at home with badger graveyards like this. So yeah, this also, I have to say, looks astonishingly good in white. I can't tell if you can see in the sun there, but that white is really fizzing and popping with pearlescence in this rare January sunshine that we're experiencing today. And yeah, I've not really been out riding for a month now because it's been either Christmas celebrating Jesus, or it's been too cold, or too wet, and then it was cold and wet, so all the roads got covered in salt and molasses, and I just didn't want to get my motorbike salty. So I've not ridden for a month today, actually, and I have noticed the effect on my mental health, but this airbox noise is a massive help chasing the blues away. And also, I didn't really want to ride my bike after a month off, because yes, the MT10 that I own, it can be docile, but it's still got 165 horsepower. I'd rather have this as a reintroduction to biking, because you do get rusty after a couple of weeks off. I get rusty if I haven't ridden for 2 weeks, and you start to lose the sixth sense that you get for other traffic and for leaning it over and all that kind of stuff. But yeah, let's talk about this bike, because I'm riding this and wondering what really I would want in addition to this in a street triple package. The brakes are really strong, the lever feels good. Well, the lever feel of the way it slows it down is good. The actual levers feel quite cheap. Non-adjustable clutch lever on this, and quite a simple brake master cylinder that you don't really notice. You've got that engine, that's kind of the star of the show for me. The dashboard is more simple on this than the RS model as well. I've got the kind of the split monochrome and colour screen there that's from the Trident originally, and now on the Daytona 660 as well. And actually, I prefer it to the one on the RS. It is more easy to read. Easier to read, that's the word. It's easier to read at a glance. You don't have to go faffing about with a million menus to see things like your rev counter. It's just there. No faffing. Also, the switch gear is cheaper on this bike, but again, I think I prefer it to the switch gear on the RS, because it hasn't got that annoying cube nipple thing. Imagine that your nipples have been put in an ice cube tray and forced in with hydraulic pressure. That's what you get. This, you don't have that. You've just got up, down, left, right arrows and a tick button and a mode button down here. So it's really easy to understand and to change your modes and your trips and things like that, which means you can focus up there more often on the cow that you're about to crash into, or the dodgy overtake you're planning, and that kind of stuff. So yeah, the mirrors are good as well on this. They're not vibey, they're nice and big. It's not trying to be trendy with bar end ones that vibrate to buggery or anything like that. It's kind of like good honest motorbike, and then you think, oh, actually it is good honest motorbike, it all sounds a little bit my first motorbike again. But then you pin it in second gear and the front tries to come up. You hook third and you are properly flying, and you have to change GoPro angles because you're breaking the speed limit. It does, if you ride one of these back to back with a Trident 660, make the Trident feel significantly less exciting. And I'm not dissing the Trident, that bike is really, really good, and it is exciting if you're coming from no motorbike. But if you get want to upgrade from a Trident to a street triple, that's a completely valid thing to do. There is a whole, there are dollops of extra performance on the table with this compared to the Trident. This is more exciting. The riding position is actually a little bit more lent forward than on, say, a Trident, and you've got a two-piece seat as well, which is quite nice, so it feels like a sports bike. But also you can ram your ass up against the pillion seat to brace yourself when you accelerate. Yeah, I like it. It feels high quality, it feels premium. Flicks from side to side with the eagerness of a well-greased bat. Can you tell that I like it? Yeah, Trident Triumph don't really make shit bikes, and this further proves that. Now, there is one curious thing, which is a slight gap in my knowledge of this bike. I was riding it from my house to where I started filming, and for the first half of that ride, I could have sworn it had a quick shifter and blipper, and it was working, and it has stopped working. If it did have one, I'm gonna have to put text up and say whether it comes with one. I thought it had one as standard, but it's definitely not working right now. I can do clutchless downshifts if I'm completely off the gas, but you would be able to normally. It's not blipping, and it's definitely not cutting the ignition on the upshift. And when it was working earlier, there was quite a big pause in the ignition as you were shifting up, and it felt like they haven't really mapped the quick shifter properly, and now it stopped working. So whatever, I'm just gonna have to shift gears myself like we had to in the olden days when there were V2s going over to bomb London. But anyway, motorbikes, it's quick as well. Had the traction control light flickering away there to tell me that the electronics are looking after me. And this bike does have a six-axis IMU brain looking after you to make sure you're not slip-sliding your way into a hedge, interrupting the delicate balance of nature as the foxes drop baby mice into the mouths of their young. So yeah, thank you Triumph's development engineers for thinking of them. I think the roads are just a bit slippery if I'm being honest. Apologies if there's loads of wind noise because I forgot my neck, but I'm only wearing a t-shirt today and I'm not regretting it too much. Also, this Street Triple has heated grips fitted. You press a button down there and you have three levels of hotness, and they work very well. Yes, good bike. Now, I'm not going to report much on the handling at this point because I just haven't ridden it enough, but I can tell you for a start, it turns in very quickly and yeah, it feels pretty good when it's lent over, but I'm not doing a whole lot of leaning it over loads because it's still slippery, the roads. Lots of mud and crap everywhere, and it's my first ride of the year and I don't really want to overstep the boundaries of my talent, which aren't especially high, has to be said. One of the best noises. If you've not ridden a three-cylinder bike, you need to. It doesn't have the outright punch of the MT09's engine, it has to be said, but this is quite a bit smaller actually. It's about 120, 150cc smaller, and you do feel it. It hasn't got the same big bike torque as that, but it's kind of more fun because you can use this and rev it out more and make the most of the revs. Anyway, that was my brief first impressions of the Triumph Street Triple R. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe if you're new to the channel because I will have a full in-depth review of this bike coming in a couple of weeks with my proper camera, and I'll walk around it and show you it in detail and talk to you a bit more about my experience. I'm hoping to do a couple of 100 miles on this in the next couple of weeks, so stick around for that. Do subscribe, like the video, go down to the comments and leave me the British word for sausage roll from Greggs. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.